Hey Wolfie, how's it going? And welcome back to the Divine Comedy Limbo. And we are in episode 2, looking for knowledge. Attaining knowledge that will help us deeper down into the world. I actually haven't read the Divine Comedy, I just kind of got a somewhat of an understanding about what it's about. But that's all. At least there are plenty of wolves here, so one person will get there eventually. I believe they'll do it. Oh, okay. So this is kind of a weird one. This is from... Ooh, I suppose I'll venture down here. Why not? So this is from the Friends at the Table Discord server. For those who don't know, Friends at the Table is, what do they call it? I wish I'd remember the term they use, but it's basically a tabletop podcast where they do, do live recordings when they play different tabletop games. And they're really good at telling good stories, so I would definitely recommend checking them out. They're really talented. They recently launched a Patreon to support newer shows. I'm really excited about that. So, this was not related to their podcast, really, but it was in that server. So, a person that actually the name got cut off, which maybe it's for the best anyway. Says that he got a burrito that on the packaging has a biblical quote. Joshua 1:9. Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. So he says, which I mean, in and of itself is a pretty okay fragment of a verse. But without context and without the God parts and on food, it just makes me wonder, what's wrong with this burrito that has to tell me not to be afraid? And then he plays us the burrito. It's just, this is gonna get pretty rough, but we'll get through this, right, man? I mean, you'll live if you eat me, but it's gonna be a wild ride. That's a funny life situation that I don't think the people who made that biblical quote on the packaging really considered. It's kind of funny. And again, it was Joshua 1:9. Be strong and courageous, dear burrito eater. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged from eating me. Yeah, it was a good time. Let's see what the next one is. It was Doc Aquatic. Let's see what the next one is. Oh yeah, and so the next one, I started reading world history. And I found this really good library, almost like someone scanned in a bunch of an old lecture book about history, especially world history, and I found that completely fascinating. It was really well written as well. It was easy to understand. I believe it was done for a school curriculum of some sort, but it's very good. And this is gonna get a bit heavy, so if you don't care for world history, which I mean is a very, in a way, only interesting to old people, which I mean I'm getting old, so if that makes sense. So this was way in the beginning about human origins. Let's read while we smelt up some stuff. So I think I want to try to read what I found interesting about this. I'm just trying to figure out what that was. This was about the Neanderthals and like the development of the human race. What made us who we are, Homo sapiens sapiens. What did I find interesting about this? Oh yeah. Evidence suggests that Neanderthals tried to explain and control their world between 200,000 and 30,000 years ago. They developed religious beliefs and performed rituals. About 60,000 years ago, Neanderthals held a funeral for a man in Shanidar Cave, located in northeastern Iraq. Some archaeologists theorize that during the funeral, the Neanderthal's family covered his body in flowers. This funeral points to belief in a world beyond the grave. Fossil hunter Richard Leakey, the son of Lewis and Mary Leakey, wrote about the meaning in this Neanderthal wrote. The Shanidar events speak clearly of a deep feeling for the spiritual quality of life. A concern for the fate of the human soul is universal in human societies today, and it was evidently a theme of Neanderthal society too. I thought that was really fascinating. Like, it's apparently just a part of us to believe that the soul lives on. Oh, Vader! And no, it's just a part of us in the core of humanity is a belief that we can't die. Like, we're aware that our body will die, but surely we can't die. Like, we're alive now. I can't think about the concept of me not existing. I thought that's completely fascinating. It's just something you don't want to consider, but it's a thing. I thought that was really fascinating. Didn't smell all that, but we'll do. So yeah, we even had religion or our belief of something beyond what we know as the world, more than the physical. And this next one, there's a lot to read here, so I kind of want to be in the safe place. I suppose I could just talk about something else I've done. I started reading a novel called The Martian, and The Martian is really good. Some of you might have seen the movie adaptation with, was it Leonardo DiCaprio? Brad Pitt? There was a famous male actor that played the main character in The Martian. I heard good things about the movie adaptation, so if that's a way you want to prefer to read about this, or get this story, then do that. I heard good things. But in general terms, The Martian is about one of the first human expeditions to Mars. And of course, things go wrong. There wouldn't be a story if things didn't go wrong, right? So, I think I'm just gonna head up. I'm done. I can't deal. And of course, yeah, what goes wrong? Well, our protagonist, there comes a storm to Mars and they have to escape, and he gets hit by a thing right before they get to the shuttle to escape, and he gets stuck on Mars. Everyone thinks he's dead, but he's miraculously survived, and now he has to figure out, why do I survive on Mars? And what a question that is. It's cool, the pseudoscience that they have there. I don't completely believe it. Like, all the different ways that he does to produce food, oxygen, water, the essentials to live. I don't believe that's the way you could do it, but, maybe. Who knows? Let me look for squid bum here. Squids are hard to find, apparently. Hey, righty peg, nice to see that, everyone. I'm proud of you. Let me get that iron. Actually, if I get one more, I can get the last iron tool. I believe it was one. And that was for, the third one was for wearing a full set of armor. So if we get some more going, there we go, and make an iron hoe, we should get one more. Yeah, look at that. And I haven't taken damage, so maybe I will get one. Oh wait, did I take damage? I don't remember damage. I don't think I saw a mob at all, really. I heard a zombie at one point, but that's pretty much it. Maybe that was it? I mean, that could be, yeah, okay. That's probably 30 minutes. Okay, let me try to not die. Probably beneficial. And you know that hunting part? Is that for me? Guys, is that a thing I should do? I don't know. I am barricaded. That's a good thing for me. I didn't even have a bow. I'm gonna be a wuss again. Yeah, you know I am. You know who I am, right, at this point. I still have so many screenshots and things to talk about. I can't do that. I can't leave you hanging. All because of you, I promise. I don't think I need this frame thing, so let me drop that and that and that. Yeah, I'm gonna stand, I'm gonna believe that's not a thing. Will happen. Hope you don't mind. I'm gonna wait. Yeah. I thought too. Wouldn't really make sense. Guess we have the do we have the egg? No, we need to find more chickens. Why did I kill all those chickens? I shouldn't gotten an egg. You probably screamed out of your screen, didn't you? Sure you did. Oh, that was a prime opportunity to get the screenshot though. What am I doing? I'm all out of my game. Out of my zone. This is a prime time to look for a squid though. Even though it's not an ocean. Maybe there's a squid to be found. This should be a good time to find do a boat thing, but I'm not gonna do a boat thing. So it maybe will save me a lot of time. Yeah, it's something to be found here, so I'm gonna go up to the right and hope I find that's the kind of feathered being feathered friend. This could be a decent way. Okay. Saving. I guess I'm gonna do that. Because basically I'm kinda I've heard of staircasing is a good thing, so I'm gonna try not do staircasing. And where that caves often go to other caves, which makes a lot of sense. I'm gonna try and do that. If you know my channel, if you've followed it for a while, you know you've seen plenty of staircase in your viewing career. I think you've had enough. The viewers have screamed out that they're done. They've seen all the staircasing that can be done. Please, I see something else. I say, fine, just this once. Yeah, let's try to keep in mind the not taking damage thing. Let's try not to be too reckless, especially around witches. But killing a witch will get me a diamond, emerald though. Oh, decisions. Another one of these, huh? Those rates are down low. Let me tell you. And let me drop that and get some good blocks on the go. Okay, actually while we're here, let's take a look at the screenshot. For those who know, I'm trying to craft a cake. That's why I got the milk buckets and look for a neck. And what was I interested in here? It's kind of interesting looking at this screenshot and trying to figure out what I was interested in at the time. This is about early advances in technology, about nomads and hunter-gatherers, the first to make tools, primitive tools, like spears. Yeah, this is kind of interesting. This, like, sort of... part of human evolution was called bone magnons, and they were the first to make needles out of bone to sew clothing out of animals. Well, no, no Iron Man emeralds for me. I'm gonna look at this chicken though until he drops the egg. I'm gonna get something out of this. Oh yeah, they were also the first part to make arch. Hey, say hey, you. I don't want you to stick around, my man. Yeah, you can just go there. Well, yeah. I'm gonna stare at you until you drop. Alright? That's how it's gonna go. I don't wanna take damage while I'm doing so. Yeah, so I guess I'll talk about Neanderthal art. Kind of interesting. The tools of early modern humans explain how they met their survival needs. Yet their world best springs to life through their artistic creations. Necklaces of seashells, lion teeth, and bear claws adorn both men and women. People ground mammoth tusk into polished beads. They also carved small realistic sculptures of animals that inhabited their world. As you probably know, Stone Age people on all continents created cave paintings. The best known of these are the paintings on the walls and ceilings of European caves, mainly in France and Spain. Here, early artists drew lifelike images of wild animals. And a cutoff. Unfortunately, I don't have more of that. That's the problem with taking screenshots, is you lose some of it. But also found a quote about their tool making. From Robert Braidwood. We found weights for digging sticks, hoe-like tools, flint sickle blades, and a wide variety of milling stones. We also discovered several pits that were probably used for storage of grain. Perhaps the most important evidence of all was animal bones and impressions left in the mud by cereal grains. The people of Jarmo were adjusting themselves to a completely new way of life, just as we are adjusting ourselves to the consequences of such things as a steam engine. What they learn about living in a revolution may be of more than academic interest to us in our troubled times. That kind of goes towards that cyclical philosophy that I'm a fan of, that mankind repeat our actions in cycles. We never truly learn from past generations because the past generations aren't there to tell us what they learned. We're just left with hints of what they wanted. We can see the art and the products they made, but we can't understand the intention of why they did it. And it's interesting that they lived in a time... Man, this guy just doesn't drop, does he? It's just not a thing for him. Wait, is that... No? Okay, I'm stuck in here with you now, huh? Well, friend, I hope you enjoy your stay. Guess I'm not getting an egg for you today. I kind of find that interesting, you know, that we all live in a revolution. We're all trying to figure out how new technology, new inventions will affect our life. For both good and bad. Okay, so map one doesn't work. That's good to know. We don't really need to care about ink. Good game. That was thin. He's out for the count. You know, I don't think there's much to this place, honestly. It looks very dark and not beneficial to me. And I don't really want to explore this because there's so much water and everything everywhere. It's like bad news. Let's take one last look at this guy. If he has nothing for us, then we head back down. Buddy! Got a neck for me, man? No? Okay, I guess I'll let you run free. Here you go. Here you go, friend. I'm sorry. At least you got some light in there, right? Yeah, I know. Oh, that's the opposite of what I wanted. Oh, buddy, I just wanted you to live in this cave. I want you to survive and make a family of your own. Why couldn't that be a thing? Why does bad things happen to good people? Why am I so bad? There's some of these things that we'll never know. Man, that hits me on an emotional level.